Huma Abedin has been by Hillary Clinton's side for 25 years, in the White House, at the State Department, on the campaign trail for two grueling runs for the presidency. But she was thrust into the spotlight when her husband, Anthony Weiner, the former congressman, was caught in a sexting scandal, destroying their marriage and possibly costing Hillary Clinton the presidency. Now Abedin is speaking out in her own words, on her terms. And joining me now is Huma Abedin, longtime aide, former campaign vice chair to Hillary Clinton. Her new memoir is titled Both and, A Life in Many Worlds. Welcome. Congratulations on this extraordinary book.
Thank you, Andrea. I'm so happy to be talking to you this afternoon.
Well, I'm so glad to see you. Well, but one thing that strikes me when reading the whole history of your connection to the Clintons, what was it like to come into the White House at a 20-year-old for the first time, to be, you know, in that extraordinary setting?
You know, there are many pinch-me moments that people have in their life, but I have to say, as a 21-year-old who, by the way, never thought she was going to end up working in the White House, never even thought she was going to end up in public service, thought she was going to grow up and be someone like you, or Christiane Amanpour, as I write in my book, it was nothing less than a goosebumpy experience. I mean, I recount the scenes in the book of walking in, inside the red, on top of that red carpet, up the marble, you know, footsteps, as somebody who spent most of her life outside of America. I grew up in Saudi Arabia and feeling, you know, this patriotism deep in my heart. It was just the most incredible experience at a young age to be able to have.
And women deal with sexism all the time, but Hillary Clinton is really unique in this regard, certainly during her first run for the presidency. And you've certainly experienced that. Have we made any progress in the way we cover women in politics?
It's one of the reasons why I chose to recount in the book in fair amount of detail. I talk about in the White House us not even as women, just not even expecting anything more. We just were grateful to have the work. But in the 2000 Senate campaign, the first time I had witnessed what it was like, what women were up against in politics at the debate that she had against the then Republican congressman who marched over the debate stage to wave a piece of paper in her hand. And then in 2008, you know, Andrea, I don't even think we knew how to deal with the sexist comments. We would laugh and giggle it off just nervously because we just assumed it was the price we had to pay to be in the game. And then in 2016, all of the outside forces that affected that race, but in part, you know, there was a lot of sexist and sexism that she had to deal with. It's hard, and it continues to be hard, and it's one of the reasons I spent so much time in the book talking, just sharing the experiences of being on the inside and what it was like to have some of those moments.
And then I will never forget that day. I think it was a trip to Iowa, 11 days before the 2016 election, and then you get the word on the flight that your emails with Hillary Clinton had somehow turned up on your husband's laptop. How do you think it affected her chances?
Well, I chose to write about it in great detail in the book. And in that moment, I was so shocked, so shattered. And as I wrote, you know, it felt selfish to even feel anything. I recount in the book how I felt responsible. I felt as if in those last 10 days, if she lost, it would be because of us. And then, sure enough, 2 days before the election, for there to be a second announcement after a first unprecedented announcement by the then FBI director was just, you know, frankly baffling to me. And in some ways, it's still baffling to me. But I carried that guilt for a very long time. It actually took me to a pretty dark place. And it took me a while to get to the other side and let go of that daily feeling of guilt over her loss, because it certainly affected the outcome of the election.
Why did you decide to be so public in writing about the problems with Anthony Weiner, with your husband?
You know, Andrea, I think that there are women, there are people in this country who go through what Anthony and I went through. Unfortunately, I wish that was not the case, but I think it is the reality. And I think the only difference is that I had to go through it on the front page of the newspapers. And I know for many years people have been, you know, telling my story, saying things they believe were my perspective. And as a result, they've been writing my history. But for me, I happen to believe things happen in life for a reason. And if there is some service, some lesson, something somebody can take away from hearing about what I went through, the struggles, the understanding, the anger, the bitterness, but that there is an other side. Suffering can be optional, that maybe my book in some ways might help people. And I can't tell you how many, mostly women, but how many people I've heard from since the book has come out sharing their stories and saying, you know, they've experienced very similar feelings as women, you know, being judged, feeling the shame when your partner has done something and you are somehow also held responsible. It's a hard road to walk down, but I'm glad if it is of service to somebody.
Well, I think it most certainly is. It's so honest and so brave. Thank you for all of that. We're just scratching the surface here on a busy Veterans Day, but with all the other coverage. But thank you very much for being with us, for writing the book, and for
Andrea. Thank you. Thank you for having me. I thank you for having me, and I really, as you know, I appreciate having you giving me the time to talk to me about my book.
Well, just the beginning.
Especially on this important day. Thank you.
Thanks, Huma Abedin. The memoir, of course, is both and a life in both worlds, in two worlds.